fourth form brass and percussion prize. Just so you're aware, guys, this year we're doing this differently to how we've always done it in the past, okay? So there's going to be a best in each year group, okay? So well done, Kieran. And a round of applause for Kieran. But importantly, there will be an overall winner of each category as well. So there'll be a percussion winner for the fourth and remove, and likewise for the brass. So there's a lot to play for, okay? And then, at the end of the day, the even bigger prize of the overall musician of the year, okay? Out of all the disciplines. So, I'd like to welcome all of our adjudicators today, but in particular for this class, we have as our brass adjudicator, Edd Leech, who's over in that corner there, Kieran. Edd studied at the Royal Northern College of Music and Royal Academy of Music, and he is an amazing tuba and player and an amazing pianist. And does lots of orchestral and chamber music. He's played with the English National Opera, Opera House, Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, BBC Concert Orchestra, and then just a few. I'm not going to go through all of them. And our percussion adjudicator today is Tom, who is in the middle of the back there, who was setting up the drums. And he studied at the Royal Welsh College of Music and Drama and the Royal Academy of Music. He's a percussionist and a drummer, and he has done so many shows in London that I won't say all of them, but including Les Miserables, if you've seen that, or Mary Poppins, Hamilton, he's done Hamilton and We Will Rock You, so he's done loads and loads of shows. So we've got two amazing adjudicators here who are going to, at the end, give you some feedback on your playing. We're really looking forward to hearing you play, so enjoy, and we'll start with Kieran.
Thank you.
Hi Kieran, what an absolute treat. Sounded lovely. You make such a beautiful sound on that trumpet. Well done. I've got so many lovely things written on my bit of paper. Your high notes, your high register is lovely. You have some brilliant intervals at the end and they were really clean, really, really impressive. Because it sounds so good, I think now you can try and think about playing out into the room. So this room is lovely. And you're playing, and it sounds great, but you're playing into the stand. And now that you're the accomplished player that you are, you can think about performing out of the room and look into the accompanist, because obviously this is accompanied by an orchestra, isn't it? It's a concerto. So you have to think about what's going on there. So if you can stand there and be free, quite often when we play, we're so rigid here and so tense, and then you can learn to be relaxed, it adds another level to your performance. Your rhythm is fantastic, your dynamics are great. I think if you want to take that to another level, you have a lovely big sound. If you can work on those quiet dynamics, it will really, really make it sound even more special. But I think it was fantastic. And you are the only person playing brass in this class, but I do think that you are absolutely a worthy winner. So well done.
Well done, Kieran. That was brilliant. Thank you very much. It was a bit of a wake-up call, which I needed. I'm just going to say a couple of things, first of all, about each of your performances, which were both brilliant. So thank you so much for that. Eric, the sort of cymbal swells at the beginning, I think you could have made like a bit more of that, maybe a bit more sort of mysterious, magical, whatever. But the grooves were really, really confident, nice and solid. I thought that those sort of pushes, you could have maybe sort of played those a little bit more confidently. They sort of maybe seemed to take you a little bit by surprise, but yeah, you kind of know what I mean there. These snare drum fills, they sounded great, but I think you can get a bit more articulation there. Just make sure they're really sort of, especially the ones that are sort of like a long sequence of semiquavers, really make sure they just get nice and nice and even. And especially in a room like this, you're up against it when it comes to articulation, because the room just sort of swallows so much in the front of the note and just ends up sounding like this big boom. So the more you can give would really, really help that. You're clearly very musical, because it was quite hard to hear the track in here, but if you ever kind of got slightly out of it, you were straight back in. So that's great, because as drummers, we really need to sort of not only dictate what's kind of happening in terms of the groove, but also we need to listen, because if a band really doesn't want to go with us, then we sort of have to go with them. Your flam sounded really good, and crucially, you utterly mastered the whole kind of looking calm whilst whilst playing the drums, which is great, because obviously we're thinking of a million things, well, we all are as musicians, so really, really enjoyed it, well done. Zak, great stuff, and yeah, lovely. I mean, don't worry about, we all sort of have fluffs every now and then, and you know, the important thing is to kind of move on from those. But the time was really good, your hi-hat was lovely and articulated, your lining up of, you know, sort of when you're playing instruments together, so your hi-hat kick together, hi-hat snare together, that was all really, really good. I think just go with a bit more confidence, and don't worry if anything happens that sort of either takes you by surprise or, you know, if something throws you, you know, it's fine. We've all been there, and it's, you know, it's the thing that sort of defines people is how they kind of go, oh, doesn't matter, it's fine, I'm just carrying on, I'm having a great time. Because, you know, as drummers, we are pretty lucky to do what we do, because it's fun. Well, you know, playing music is fun. And right, so I am going to give the prize to